मदः पूर्णमिदम् पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। We were seeing the Agni Upasana, Upasana of Virat in the Agni. And before the Upasana of Virat in the Agni, glorification of Agni was done. In that glorification of Agni, if you remember, Srishti was taken. And one line was said that before the creation, nothing was there. To explain that line, we had taken, first was the Buddhists were taken, so, and then Asat Karanavad was taken and Asat Karyavad was taken. So Asat Karanavad was taken, if you remember, that it is not possible that something is there, and from nothing something has come. There is no proof for that. There is something called Anuman Praman and something is called Pratyaksha Praman. So if I see you directly, this is Pratyaksha or Anuman? Pratyaksha. But when I see a smoke and I infer a fire, that is Anuman or knowledge by inference. Okay. But remember one thing, inferential knowledge is based because this person has seen the smoke and fire together somewhere in the past. That is called Vyapti Gyan. If somebody has not seen the association of fire and the smoke, he won't be able to infer that wherever there is a smoke, there will be fire. So if somebody says, no, from nothing world has come, so this is not possible because there is no proof, there is no pramana to say that from nothing something has come out. You are saying that from nothing something has come. This is your postulation. So there is no proof. You cannot give any one example to prove that from nothing something has come out, because you are there to see that. We saw that in the morning. And therefore this is Asat Karanavad is refuted. To refute the Asat Karyavad, that the pot was not existing in the clay or the Srishti was not existing in a potential form before the creation. So there were four points we had seen in the morning. If you remember, I am not going to repeat all, I have to move forward. So first was Abhivanjak, Abhivanjakatvat. Second what? Vipratishedhat. Dusra, third was Sarvagya Apramanyat. And fourth was Abhavatvat. Of those who have interest, please go into it. If you don't have too much of interest, don't worry. Do anything, but don't worry. So this, but what is the problem? If I say that before the creation is started, what is the problem? Problem will be that you are saying that if there is a start of something, then the problem will be who made it. Maker and made will be different. And when maker and made is different, so Jeev will be different than the Ishwar. And Ishwar will be finite. Ishwar will be finite and Jeev will be different than the Ishwar. And therefore, Jeev can never be Anand. So, Akhandatva of Jeev is not proved. Okay. And this is the Christian philosophy and the Muslim philosophy is based on Ishwar is the Nimitta Karan but not the Upadan Karan. Sorry, what is this two words? New words come on. One is called Nimitta Karan, efficient cause. Other is called Upadan Karan, material cause. Have you heard these names? I hope you have heard. If you have heard, it is good. If you have not heard, please hear it. I'll give you in short. Upadan Karan is that yat upadaya karyam pravartate tat upadan, taking which some effect comes out. And how do you know what is the Upadan Karan? After destruction of the kam, karya, wherever that goes, that is called Upadan. If I break the pot, pot will go into mud. Clay or mud. Therefore, mud is the Upadan. Pot won't go to the potter. Pot won't merge with the potter. And therefore, where the after taking away the shape, where it goes, that is called Upadan Karan. This body is there. So when this body dies away, it goes back to five element. Five element it goes. And therefore the five elements are the Upadan Karan. What is the Nimitta Karan? That which gives the shape to the Upadan Karan is called Nimitta Karan. Right? Potter gave the shape to the pot. Therefore potter is the Nimitta Karan, efficient cause. Mud is not the Nimitta Karan. Okay? What is the efficient cause or the Nimitta Karan of this body? Karma phal, yes. Karma is the one which gives the shape. Somebody became woman, somebody became man, somebody became crocodile. Five elements are same. And somebody became devata. So this karma is the Nimitta Karan, is the one which gives the shape to a particular Upadan Karan. If Ishwar is the Nimitta Karan and not the Upadan Karan, this is what Nayayik say, then the problem will be Ishwar has to be in his space, number one. Number two, Ishwar will be different than the world, therefore Ishwar will be finite, he'll die away. Number three, that Jeev can never be one with the, it cannot be akhanda. So Jeev will never be infinite. So his mukti always will be in some dham. So definition of mukti in different places is different. He will go to some golok, saket log, but he will never be the one who became one with all. Okay, and then by knowledge mukti won't be there. Because knowledge doesn't make anything. Knowledge just unveils something. And therefore so much of effort has been put to tell that the asat karyavad is not true. That means before the creation, that pot was existing in the potential form. Okay. Now last point, five points I had promised. As per the Bhashya, last point he is saying asat sambandh abhavat. Earlier abhavatvat was there. Last point is asat sambandh abhavat. What is there? Very simple. This refutation is based on the fact that when pot was not existent, and when pot was not existent, so what happened? Pot maker begins the work on the clay. Okay? Clay. He mixes the clay with what? No. He has mixed with what? Don't make pot. That is already done. When clay is mentioned, it means when clay is mentioned, oh my God, when clay word itself is indicating the moldable clay. But to make the pot, he mixes the clay with his mental shape of the pot. That shape which is already in his mind, he is using that shape to put, he is associating that existent shape of the pot in the mind with the clay. Okay. Supposing you are making a mithai or you are making something, and some matter is there. You are using the existing shape of that recipe in your mind with the only matter which is available. Supposing a wheat flour is there, atta is there, you are mixing that. So that was not non-existent. It existed in some form as the shape in your mind. Okay, got my point. So what Nayayik said, non-existent pot got intimate with the clay and borrowed the existence of the clay, and then it came out as a pot. Again I will say, Nayayik said that pot which was non-existent, it got intimate with the clay and it borrowed the existence from the clay, and then it is called a pot. So there is a mixture of the existent clay with the non-existent pot. Then Vedantin said, 1 minute, how did you say non-existent pot when that pot was already in the form of the mind? It was existing as a thought form, it was existing as some concept form. So that clay, that pot was not totally non-existent, number one. Number two, how can existence mix with non-existence? I enjoy all these things. Well, you enjoy, I suffer. So, sambandh or the relation is possible between two existent things, but from the non-existent girl, existent boy cannot marry. Existent boy can marry with the existent girl only. So with the non-existent pot, the clay cannot mix. So therefore the clay and the pot share the same level of reality, and then they got mixed up. And this was the last argument. So it is said, sat sat sambandha asti, sad asatoho sambandha nasti. The relation is between two existent things and not between one existent and one non-existent. And therefore conclusion is, srishtehe purvam karyam asti. And therefore conclusion is, before the creation, the world was existing in the potential form, which is called pralaya. In pralaya, everybody's fruits of action are there, your own nature is there. And when this jeev will come out after billions of years, he will have the same nature. And his prarabdha is all well stored, in cold storage it is there. Not that Bhagwan some prarabdha got lost. last birth, last kalp I was mathematician and now I forgot mathematics. Now I have become politician. So you can't say like that. So everything is retained. Because at the time of release, all these things were there in a potential form. I hope this much is clear for you. And this proof, this is enough for the negation of asat karanvad and asat karyavad. Learn to have some new words. Every day we should study something new. Hear something new. Maybe difficult, but let us go and challenge your intellect. You'll feel happier. You'll feel more fresh. It is called in Sanskrit as pratibha. Bha bha prati iti is pratibha. Some pratibha should be there. Now, this topic, this ghat bhash is over. Thank God it is over. So, now after that, Bhashyakar uses one small point. If you see the mantra, see the third mantra, what is that? This mantra you see, first mantra, page 46. Naiva kinchan agre asin. This is one sentence. After that, full stop is there. When we study in Gurukul, I make them do full stop. So that they don't get confused where sentence is ending. In Sanskrit, punctuation is very less mentioned. Full stop, comma, semicolon, exclamation, question mark. Why? Because this knowledge was given by Shruti, by word. Word. Teacher was speaking and student were by hearting it. Therefore, not all these things are not a part in that. So you have to mark it. So the teacher used to take a pause. That pause itself means that there is a full stop. Only you say viram and purnivaram. One line is there and two lines are there. This is comma, etc. We put it. Because this was not by writing. It was called Shruti, it was heard, and students used to by heart it. And therefore, even after the manuscripts were destroyed, because it was in the mind, therefore they could reproduce it. Okay, I hope you are clear. After that, Bhashyakar says, see one more line. Next line, please see. After Asit, you can say full stop. Full stop, you can put one line if you want. Then it is said, Mrityuna ev idam avritam asit. You saw that. Mrityuna ev, page 26, Mrityuna ev idam avritam asit. By the Mrityu, all this was covered. What does this mean? He said, even if you don't believe what I said in two classes, Mrityu means Hiranyagarbha. I will explain what is Hiranyagarbha. Mrityu means Hiranyagarbha. And idam means whole world. Whole world was covered by Hiranyagarbha. So something non-existing cannot be covered. Something existing can be covered by existing. Neither non-existing can cover the non-existing. Neither existing can cover the non-existing. Got my point? So what you are saying, both is refuted in this line by the Shruti itself. Okay, see the word here. Mrityuna eva idam avritam asit. So Mrityu here means karanam Hiranyagarbha. And idam means karyam, called the world. So this Hiranyagarbha had covered the world. Covered means unmanifested. Without name and form. Non-functional. It was in the non-functional state. Like when I'm not talking, my speech is non-functional. But power of speech is there. You can't say I cannot talk. No, power of speech is there. Also it is not functional. And it is possible I can cover my power of speech. If I don't want to talk, I will say, no, I'm not talking. So I can use that. So similarly, existent Hiranyagarbh, I think I have not used the word Hiranyagarbh, I will come back to it. Existent Hiranyagarbh has covered the existent world, and therefore, there is a Karya also in the potential form, and Karan also of this Jagat. So Jagat is not without the Karan and Karya. Therefore, what is the conclusion? Conclusion is, before Srishti, both are there, and this clarifies our point. So what the commentary was there in Ghatbhashya, I have tried to summarize it in few points. If you are very, very interested, you please go and read it.